Hello, everybody. This is Girish Nair, and welcome back to the final leg of the webathon being organized by WOW Mind and Behavioral Clinic, Chennai, India. This is while we are observing World Suicide Prevention Day on the 10th of September. Leading to that day, we have been making efforts at WOW to create more awareness about how to identify people who are undergoing depression and how to save lives. That's the end goal. Every life saved is a precious life saved at the end of the day. It doesn't matter how many lives we've saved. So there is this one question that everybody has on their minds. Do celebrities even have problems? This is about celebrities today that we are having this session. Do they even have problems? Because they lead a very high life. What we see on the media, in the media, is all about success that we see of them. So we often forget, though, that celebrities are human beings. After all, they're like just like you and me. That we tend to forget, and we expect them to always be happy and successful and always joyous. But that's not the case. Every human being has similar problems, if not the same, could be different as well. It is even more important that awareness is created amongst people about suicide prevention and about the misconceptions related to an idea that celebrities themselves are attempting suicide. So what's wrong with me choosing that option to end all the misery? And sadly, this is a misconception. Raising awareness of the possible negative effect of celebrity suicides through suicide prevention programs in the community has become all the more essential today. Research around the world shows an association between celebrity suicides or death and a subsequent increase in the suicide rate. In addition, though, media coverage of suicide across many, across various media like print or television, show that their coverage of suicide cases may influence suicidal behavior in others, as well as the choice of the suicide method. This is something that was discussed in the previous session as well. On the other hand, there are a lot of celebrities who are brave enough to talk about the mental illness issues they suffered and are now living normal, healthy, and happy lives. This topic in this session is about giving a very clear message to people that everybody has problems and there are ways to overcome all our problems. However, suicide is never the solution. Our life is more important than the problem. So how do we look at that? A spate of celebrity suicides has left many of us, of course, bewildered as to what could depress them so much that they take their precious lives away at their prime, very young age, especially at the time when they are doing really well and have promising careers ahead of them. Reaching great heights amidst the ever-shining glare of public life might be a daunting challenge to those who we celebrate. A minor slip, just a minor slip, a moment's distraction might trigger severe reactions. It requires a distinct emotional balance to deal with success and failure in full public glare. Let's learn about these essential qualities from a person who has seen the struggles of life and the pinnacle of success and acclamation. Our special speaker for this session today is Dr. Mohan Agashe. So Dr. Agashe, in addition to being a psychiatrist, has been acknowledged as one of the finest actors on the stage and screen in the 70s and 80s in India. Many of us, especially I'm sure I have grown up watching a lot of his works. He is the founder, director, professor of Maharashtra Institute of Mental Health in Pune and retired from that position in 2005. He has worked as an advisor in the mental health to the government of Maharashtra, India from 2006 to 2009. His current interest and work is on applied importance of cinema in health awareness and education. Recipient of the prestigious, let me try and pronounce this, it's a German term, for the prestigious the Cross of Order of Merit from the President of the Federal Republic of Germany in 2002. It's called Bundesverdienstkreuz. So that's how it's pronounced. And the Sangeet Natak Academy Award for Theatre, that's the highest national honor in arts in 1996. That's when he was conferred that award. And he was also conferred the Padma Shri by the President of India in 1990. That's Dr. Mohan Akashe for you, ladies and gentlemen. Happy to have him here. So once we get him online, the floor will be his.
So, shall we go straight to the topic?
Yes, sir. The topic for you is Zen at the Zenith, maintaining mental balance at the pinnacle of success, largely focusing on celebrity suicides and how people look up to celebrities and suddenly somehow, you know, get the notion that celebrities can also have problems. They're surprised. And on the other hand, they also believe that if celebrities, such successful people choose suicide as an option, why can't I? So these are the various concerns that we seem to be battling. The floor is yours, sir.
First of all, let me start by making a very simple statement that all of us, starting from the Prime Minister to a very common man who comes and cleans everything, we all are primarily human beings. And we stand on a common platform. There are a number of things where there are common things. Like you sleep, so does the Prime Minister. So does any famous, non-famous person. He gets hungry. He has needs. So there are plentiful needs. At one level, we all are same. So like one somebody said about, I think Osho Rinesh, that sex is the lowest form of love. Which is true. Because from everybody needs it, because it's a need. It's a biological need. Similarly, hunger is a biological need. So there are some biological factors which are common to all of us. So basically, all of us are human beings. And to make it very simple, I'm taking it to a very primary level. When are we called a being? And when we are called non-being. So you have to really go back to a moment which you won't remember, but your parents will, is when you are born. Right. Now, what is this process of birth? The process of birth is interesting. One mass of matter comes out of another mass of matter. Technically speaking, biologically speaking, and factually speaking, there is a mass of matter which is growing, which we call pregnancy. And at one point of time, this being is already being, throws out from her body a mass of matter, which you can see as an independent mass of matter. But that mass of matter is not designated as being. Why? Because it's not functioning yet. On that independent mass of matter, new mass of matter, takes his first breath, which is called birth cry, which is not actually birth cry. It's the beginning of respiration. Right? Then everybody is relieved. But even then, he's not designated as being because he still has to do one more function. And only when he does second function, then first of all, he has to sustain the first function he has. And if he is able to sustain that function, then that new mass of matter gets independence. by cutting the umbilical cord. Now, the new mass of matter is not linked with the main mass of matter. So like Earth has come from the sun, this new mass of matter required second important function or vital function is called circulation. So on acquisition of two functions, we are designated as a being. Means what is designated means now you can go to the birth death registry and enroll yourself as a new being. Right? And then somewhere, wherever it is, after a few years, either these two functions stop suddenly or gradually, then you are designated as a non-being. So again, you go to the same office to register what is called death. But death cannot be registered unless your heart stops and your breathing stops. But once that is done, you are designated as a non-being. And that mass of matter then is a meaningless mass of matter again. And then it's disposed of. So what we have to understand basically, death as a process is end of the biological instrument, which is the host to various functions, starting with breathing and circulation till you finish those. So when that mass of matter becomes functionless, that is called death. Now, therefore, there is a difference between, now we can come to suicide and a right to die. Nowadays in medical sector, you must be reading, there's a lot of debate. And in fact, there are many countries which promote and justify right to die. So the main difference between suicide and suicide, death by suicide and death by right to die, both are deaths, but both are very, very different deaths. So we won't go to right to die because we have to focus on suicide. Suicide is probably a death which is accidental. Why it's an accidental death? Because one is not sure that it is as a right to die one has committed. Suicide is not an act with full awareness of right to die. Suicide leads to death because you think you have lost meaning of life, which is actually not meaningless life. But for you, for the individual, it has become meaningless. Again, that individual may be a celebrity or may not be a celebrity. But that thought or that feeling probably comes from unbalanced state of mind. And so obviously we have to see what is mind. Mind is non-tangible thing. And you can't find mind by cutting the brain, which everybody thinks now 10 days, the decade of brain research, they've been trying to find that mind, and there's a debate whether mind exists in brain or heart. But not getting into that, what they're trying to find out are the various centers in the brain which control different functions of mind, like emotion and thinking and orientation and awareness. Like when you are aware today, when you are aware between self and others, between what you think and what. So as I was saying, the functions of mind. So mind is not brain. Mind is not heart. Mind is not any organ in the body. First of all, mind is not an organ. So what is mind? Mind is the content of body. And body is the form, temporary form, acquired by the mind for functioning. Like music temporarily finds its residence in piano or in flute or in vocal cords. So music is the content of the instrument. Instrument itself is not music. But you have to keep the instrument tuned so that it can produce music and not noise. And when your content is well organized, you care for your functions, both bodily and non-bodily. Then your instrument is well tuned. Any instrument, you must have found out that before they start playing or even before somebody starts singing, what he does is he gets tuning. He does tuning. So what is the importance of body? Because that's the instrument which we have till we die by any reason. So mind is the content of body. So in simple terms, body is a container. Mind is the content. So your body is the laddu ka dabba. And mind the laddu. Now, have you understood this? You have to know the difference. That celebrity suicide becomes a topic of gossip because it's publicized. Because the life of a celebrity, whether it is in films, theater, music, politics, whatever it is, gradually loses its privacy. So anything he does or she does becomes a focus, because without they telling anybody, people can have them as role models and follow them for different things. That is why celebrity suicide is treated differently by rest of the world, though the suicide per se is not different. And it probably happens because it can be an impulse. Strong impulse where you are alone and there is. So it's almost like even a road accident. There's a road accident, you have a grievous injury, but no help comes on time. So So you lose your life. When you have no desire to die, this accident, suicide, is primarily an accidental death. We have come, and that is why after a long battle, today is not considered a crime. But you know the legal battle one had to go through. You know? And therefore the stigma which got attached to suicide and end of life. So first of all, suicide is an accidental death. An accidental death of a celebrity becomes a gossip. Because you don't come to know the facts, which otherwise in an ordinary person, probably, since it is not publicly discussed, the near and dear ones have probably got the, hints. And actually studying those hints, today we have come to conclusion of health lines, talk it out. No. People don't talk of suicide, suicidal thoughts, depressive thought because of stigma. Stigma comes from publicity, wrong information about an accidental death. Fact of the matter is, as a doctor, you know, and probably I know, when we run emergency days in the hospital, generally we used to get 3 to 4 cases of attempted suicide on every emergency. And that time the commonest was organophosphorus compound. 95% of people attempting suicide generally resort to means from which they can be saved. And the way it's done is they are found. Or they themselves go to the hospital after committing the act of attempting. Because only after doing that act they realize that actually they don't want to die. It's more attention seeking. Now we can find one good between celebrity suicide and attention. One of the, you can say, toxic effects or side effects, popular and being a celebrity, you get used to attention. Too much attention. So it's like getting addicted to alcohol. You get addicted to that attention. And then you want to sustain that attention. And anything which disturbs that. But the paradox is, you become celebrity because of certain extraordinary talents or traits which you have. And you don't start those traits to become a celebrity. But because you have those qualities, and if those qualities match the function you are doing, you automatically become a celebrity. Otherwise, try, make an attempt to become a celebrity. Nobody can become a celebrity. So now it's an inbuilt thing that you have certain qualities which are so exceptional that people start noticing you. You become famous, you become celebrity. And then you get used to being famous rather than focusing on the activities which made you famous. And that may lead to an imbalanced state of mind. So, in suicide, must differentiate two things definitely. One is a very planned and a thoughtful suicide, which could definitely either be because of major depression. As you know, major depression is a major emotional disturbance. It can be unipolar or bipolar. Either of you. And that state can even lead to some tremendous creative work. If you have read paper by Dr. N.N. Wigg, he has deciphered the poetry of Mirza Ghalib. And he has classified the poetry done in a manic phase and poetry done in a depressive phase. So having a strong emotion is like having a weapon with two edges. Dudhari bolte na, two cutting edge. It can be productive if you are creative. And if it goes wrong direction, you cut yourself with that. So that belongs to the category of losing the balance of mind in an emotional disorder. And there it is impulsive, more often than not, and not really planned, like a suicide in a thought disorder. And many times the death in celebrity suicide can be because of a wrong judgment. In fact, in many suicides we found people have died when they don't want to die because of error of judgment. Planned suicide can be a very pseudo-philosophical thought. What is pseudo-philosophical? Pseudo-philosophical thought is one must die at the height of ecstasy, because that's the best moment of life and you're not going to get any better moment of life after that. So why not lose life when you are at your best feeling? This is pseudo-philosophy. And the main reason for that is the mathematics and formula of emotion multiplied or divided by thought does not bring the right sum. Thought and emotion disorder. So in plan, if it is not a pseudo philosophical thing, it is you have reached the conclusion, long-lasting conclusion. That is. Third important point, I think, is like all doctors and marketing people think, and the way we talk, positive thinking, suicide preventable, correct? It's a preventable thing, but does not mean every suicide is preventable. And number of my friends and psychiatrists who are good, who who have been treating cases well, probably bringing hope to the patient and the family. And many times you realize that this evening you have seen the patient, he's happy, good, has gone home. And middle of the night or early morning, you get call from the parents or relatives that he jumped and died this morning.
We often come across these.
Yes. And it's very common. So this is a market technique. It's not a realistic statement. But why then we make it? Because majority of suicides can be preventable if the condition is identified. Like cancer, if detected early, you can remove it. Death is unavoidable in any case. Death is a part of life, not disease. But there's a difference between a natural death, like natural birth, and taking a decision to die. That's the right to die. That's a different era, different area. Celebrity suicide becomes a suicide per se is not different from any other person's suicide, except that the impact of it is felt not only by near and dear ones, impact of it is felt by a huge population. One. Second difficulty in suicide celebration is, like a normal person, normal person is or is non-celebrative person. Non-celebrative person is not necessarily as lonely as celebrities are. And this forced loneliness is one of the toxic effects of being a celebrity. It's not because you don't want privacy, but you just can't get it.
It's not self-imposed
or imposed by the crowd on you.
Right.
You want to enjoy private, but you can't. And so maybe with surrounded by security people, you feel completely distanced. Forced loneliness, not by choice, but by force, affects a person much more at subconscious and unconscious level than at conscious level is enjoying the status of a celebrity. That is one major differentiating point between suicide of a celebrity. And the second, the amount of distortion after the suicide of a celebrity is unmatchable. Very soon it gets converted into a thriller, into subject for series, subject for dramatic creativity, or whatever it is. Finding similarities and everything. So sometimes there is a romantic angle to a suicide. which my wrong thinking celebrated to. Unrecognized also because it's a congenital, what do you call it? Like you have a hole in the heart. Because the reasons which make you celebrate are those congenital defects in your personality traits. And so you can become very romantic also about that. That even my death will be like that. So they are not as amenable to treatment as a non-celebrity can be. So one has to be very careful of being a celebrity. If you start realizing you are gradually become celebrity, always remember, first, you are a human being, where I started my presentation. And never lose the ground. Keep your feet on the ground, wherever your head is. Status of celebrity takes you in a different world. And with that, if you lift your feet also, you are at more risk of suicide. So remember to be on the ground, even if you are a celebrity. That's the way I would like. I'll take questions if you have.
Thank you so much, sir. Yes, sir. We do have questions. The first question is somebody who's asked, why do suicides by celebrities spark copycat suicides? What can you do? I think we've already answered that as you spoke. There's another question. Is there some way to remain calm and balanced despite success or failure?
Yes, of course. Although a lot of people have. I mean, if you take a person like Jayan Narulkar, somebody I know. You take a person like Atal Bihari Vajpayee.
Right.
Both are celebrities.
Correct.
Maturity. And maturity is a different thing. But there are people who are mature and celebrated. Take Amitabh.
Yeah.
There are people. So, see these two things. Very difficult, they don't go hand in hand many times, especially in the celebrity circle of artists. Because artists basically have different perception of life.
Right.
That's why I become the artist. So they primarily are more vulnerable for mental imbalance compared to a non-celebrity.
Right, sir. Question number two. In what ways can we use the medium of theater to help people with mental health issues?
Actually, we need a separate webinar on this.
Okay.
Because the answer is not that short, because you have to think how we have changed over 500 years or more. Starting with non-verbal.
Yeah.
Coming to words and oral tradition, where all information, knowledge were transmitted through oral medium, which was replaced by written medium when printing technology came. So before oral and written era, lot of function, lot of importance was to image and sound, which is used by films now. See, imagine that time communication. It was like Charlie Chaplin. Yes. Sounds, not words.
Right.
Sounds and images. Then word came. The moment written word came, it replaced. Writers replaced the orators. Now in the digital era, all have come together. The family is reunited with this instrument. It has image, sound, and word.
Yes.
So the normal language of written word is completely spoiled. Even oral is fine. But with the major difference, we learn the language of word, particularly written word, for 15, 20 years, because it's compulsory in school. Language of image and sound is not compulsory. So there is a lag between development of your cognition and development of your sensitivity. That is why Mark Twain said, I didn't let school interfere with my education. He was able to keep his sensitivity. That is important. And so this question is much deeper and requires more elaborate answer. But if you get these guidelines, then you can even try to find the answer.
Absolutely. Fantastic. Thank you, sir. And I just have a couple of more questions. Okay. Here's the next question. Somebody, unfortunately, I have the name of the questioner from the participant here. Shanawaz Shanuddin, student of Government Law College, Mumbai. So here's the question. How can we prevent suicide in our country, and how can we generally treat the mentally ill people? It's a very generic question he's asked. So how do we treat mentally ill people? And how do we prevent suicides in our country?
I asked him, how do we prevent physical ailments? Not by treatment, but being aware of our habits.
Right.
Health has become a marketing concept now. That is why Corona has given us need. We have gone back to basics, washing hands, keeping distance.
Yes.
All this used to come earlier as good habits.
Yeah.
Healthy habits.
Yeah.
So if you focus on healthy habits and don't become greedy to live 60 years life in 30 years so that you get more life. That is a way that is then preventable. But that does not mean that you will be able to prevent everything. No. That's a very utopic concept. Event. When you walk on the road, keep your eyes and ears open so that you see where the dangers are. And decide, avoid it, jump over it, face it. There are various defense mechanisms which you can use. And that way, we can keep it under control. World will not become free of illnesses ever, mental or physical.
And one last question, sir. From your own experience, how have you ever felt extremely dejected? What did you do to feel better?
Have I ever felt completely dejected?
Yeah, from in your own experience, have you ever felt extremely dejected? And what did you do to feel better?
If I have to remember, means it wasn't so bad. Okay. Otherwise, I would have remembered very quickly. Okay. But yes, you can feel, and it's not abnormal. In fact, the way to become rich is not by how much money you have, but how many varieties of emotions you are able to experience and still continue to live. So if you look at the road ahead, instead of the ditch where you just went in, you fall in the ditch. If you think that's the end of life, then no. But before falling, you know, oh, the road is there. If you develop it as an attitude, then it's much easier to combat with these kind of feelings. And also realize and keep somebody always at hand so you can fall back. You already think you're feeling low. You know who you should go to.
Yeah. Right, right. Perfect, sir. Yeah. Thank you, sir. Sir, are you able
to... I've done film, as you must be aware.
Of course.
That in 2016, yeah. Knowing that depression has become a major second cause in young people, particularly age group 15 to 29. I worked with one excellent filmmaker, Sumitra Bhavil, and produced a film called Casa of Turtle, which got President Golden Lotus. That's one of, you asked me what is the best way, without being directly didactic. It tells you and helps you to understand the process of depression and its resolution, without being didactic. I hope some wise person and not a only downright commercial businessman thinks it is important that people see it. Because people love it after seeing it. But seeing people are only after money, they are trying to produce more patients than trying to help the recovery. But I hope somebody finds it and you will be able to see it.
Sure, sir. We hope so too. Yes, sir. Sir, are you able to take any more questions? Maybe a question or two if any comes up?
One or two.
Okay, sir.
Sir, I would like to ask a question.
Yeah. Please introduce yourself.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Aapka naam, please?
Shahnawaz.
Shahnuddin. Shahnawaz again. Yes, please go ahead, Shahnawaz.
Sir, how can suicide be highlighted as a social evil?
Highlighted as a social evil?
Yes, sir.
Well, I just told you about a film, Casa.
According to you, sir, according to you.
So, making a good product, not didactic, not appealing only to intelligence, but appealing to your sensitivity and making you think. See, दूसरे के खाने से हमारा पेट नहीं भरता, दूसरे के पढ़ने से हम होशियार नहीं बनते.
Yes, sir, definitely.
So the best way is go for these kind of films where the film finishes, but thinking begins for you.
Definitely, sir.
And that is what these, there are a couple of short films also. And this film Castle. और ये बात ऐसी है, a thing to experience. The experiential wisdom cannot be replaced by cognitive intelligence.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Shanavas, for your question. Thank you,
thank
sir.
Thank you so much.
Sir, I have one question. Sir, excuse. Sir, I'm from
shoot,
Tamil Nadu.
Shoot. Shoot a question.
Effective to address the suicide, the cinefield, cinema, or street theater, or playback theater, which media is effective for eliminating the suicide or address?
It's not the theater.
Even
the person who is going to do that theater, how good he is, and see, all good therapists choose the mode of therapy in which they are best. Therapy is never best. A practitioner has to be best.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
so much.
Welcome. Bye.
Well, sir, we should thank you because you've taken your personal time out for us, and it's a great honor to have you here. And the kind of conversation we have had, all that we heard from you, I think we are going back from this call, from this webinar, with a lot of information, lots of points to ponder over. And this is going to touch many lives, I'm sure. And thank you so much for your sharing your wisdoms.